This is a Hot Pie Media original.
So I'm nerding out reading Forbes, 4 o'clock in the morning, and then I stumbled across, you know, I'm a big fan of free enterprise. I love risk reward. I applaud entrepreneurs. I applaud risk takers. It's such a beautiful concept. It's never perfect. You know, I like to lecture people and say, free enterprise always comes with a bloody nose, but man, it is risk reward is such a beautiful thing. I mean, you think about most of the tenets of this country, up until recently, have really been a beautiful thing. This whole city that I live in with cranes going up all over the place, it's because of risk reward. I'm a huge fan. I don't even know what risk reward you want to take, but good for you. What a beautiful country. Did you know? I think you probably did know this. Can I warn you, I'm probably going to sound a little bit like a dad in just a few minutes, you know, where I want to put my daughter in bubble wrap for the next 16 years. So pardon me when I go dad on you. Did you know the path to wealth? I don't even think it's arguable, but I'm going to say the path to wealth. Did you know that it's dancing with kind of a big belly and a baggy sweatsuit? Did you know that? That's how to get rich? Yeah, I have a hook nose, a baggy sweatsuit. That's the path to wealth. No, not at all. Free enterprise, students, put your laptops up for a second. Let's talk about risk reward. Let's talk about free enterprise. Let's talk about it. Some of us have been left behind. Free enterprise is now at its best. Look, I'm proud of you for taking advantage of free enterprise. I'm not so proud of you for how you took advantage of free enterprise. In fact, I might say in a dad-like moment, this is precisely what we try to teach our daughters not to do. This is not the world, but it is the world. So this is free enterprise. This is free enterprise at its best. And this is free enterprise at its worst. You can pick a spot. I might add, again, to sound like a dad, this is free enterprise at its best, this is free enterprise at its worst, and this is free enterprise at its pervy self. And I said pervy. You pervs. Sorry. Didn't know free enterprise had a pervy side, did you? Oh, yes, it does. Absolutely. In fact, seems to me, The greatest accumulation of wealth per second, and I'm trying to compare now. You know, we got Austin's own Elon Musk, who lives, you know, went to Bowie High School from Southwest Austin, lives over there. He and his loving wife, Grimes, their child, Pi R Square, the whole family is here. But Elon Musk, I don't know per second who's making the most money, but an amateur observation would be the most money per second would be, oh, I don't know, dancing in a thong. No, it's not crypto, it's not software, it's not batteries, sure the hell not oil. It's pretty much dancing in a thong. I think that is the fastest wealth accumulation per second of anything I can think of. I said per second, not even per minute. It's thong per second. That's the path to wealth, young people. Okay. TikTok is the devil. There's the dad. Dad says TikTok is the devil, okay? I'm going to sound like Kenneth Copeland before we're done. I'm going to blow TikTok out of here. TikTok is the devil, so damn TikTok. TikTok is brilliant. Brilliant. This is when I admire risk takers. I admire coders. I admire chip developers. Think about you. You sit there in your Star Trek shirts, and you have come up with an invention that is creating wealth at a rate we haven't seen, since Facebook. You're creating wealth for pervy dudes to watch teenagers. What a brilliant move. What if anybody ever said, across the cubicle, said, hey, I was going to say Fred, but I don't think his name was Fred. It's a Chinese company. Fred, you know we're going to get rich, but it's really a bunch of dudes watching teenagers dance in a thong, right? Yeah, whatever. So the Forbes list, it used to be a Forbes list of the wealthiest people in the world. Then it became the Forbes list of wealthiest Americans. Then it became the Forbes list of wealthiest under 40, and then the Forbes list of richest TikTokers. I've noticed something on the TikTok list, because I'm not, I think it's the devil as a parent. I've noticed something. There are not any fat guys on the list. In fact, I don't think there's any guys on the list. Huh. How'd that happen? All right. So you do the math. Do the math on dollars. Millions of dollars per minute. You go ahead and do the math on that. And I think we've stumbled onto something here, that there seems to be a direct correlation between a spray tan, super fit body, a thong, and dancing. All right, here's the Forbes list.
John McClellan is the co-founder and creator of ATX Hot Sauce, now in all 50 states and several retail outlets as well. So what we're going to do today is we're going to let this social media rock star chef walk us through four different sauces, and then I'll taste, and we'll tell everyone why they should buy. You can give the science behind these, and then I'll make the simple recommendation. Go to atxhotsauce.com. All right, so let's go.
I don't think anybody's heard the website.
Yeah, I know. I know.
By you, Jeff, it is atxhotsauce.com.
I'll say 345 times, atxhotsauce.com. So let's do it.
I brought four flavors here, and we're going to test your palate today.
Okay.
And I only brought four because I didn't think you could handle five or six.
Yes,
probably
enough.
A smart move. Yeah. And so the first one we're going to try here, it's called Beet Heat. And just like the name implies, it has beets in it. It's made with red Fresno peppers. Red Fresnos are red peppers that are they're hotter than a jalapeno and a little bit less than a serrano. So not super hot here, just a lot of good, really good flavor. So we're going to start with this one, and then we're going to move up the chain.
Okay. I've had the beet heat, but okay.
Yeah, we're going to try it, though.
It goes well with a cab. All right, Jeff's savoring beet
heat. I'll even do it with you, so that should be all right. Now, remember, it is hot sauce.
Yeah. Oh, it is. It's hot sauce. Trust me, man.
Is that one hot to you?
No. A little.
Yeah. The great thing with the fermentation process is you get a bunch of the flavor right up front.
Yeah.
And then the heat comes, but then it dissipates pretty quickly, especially with red Fresnos. You know, this is not a very spicy one, but it is a very tasty one. It goes on great on sandwiches.
Beet heat.
B-E-E-T. Heat.
All right, go to atxhotsauce.com.
That's right.
The highest earning TikTokers. Wow. This just makes me think, I stand in front of a lecture hall in front of like 200 students all trying to invent the next thing. And maybe I should just say, shut up and just go dance. Get out of here. Get out of my class. It doesn't matter. What am I even doing up here? Why have you read 12 books already this semester? It doesn't matter. You know what? Just get a spray tan and go dance. Forget me. Forget us. Leave us behind. Now, there is this risk to sound like your dad that, I don't know, when you hit, 21, it's over. Is anyone over the age of 20 allowed on TikTok? I'm confused. Apparently not. All right, so here we go. The Forbes list. I laugh in admiration and I throw up on my shoes in disgust. January 7, Forbes list highlights the highest earning TikTok stars of 2021. Collectively, the highest earning TikTok stars of 2021 made $56 million last year. All of them are male above the age of 45. That's a lie. None of them. I don't think any of them are male at all, and I don't think any of them are above the age of 25. I'm not sure anyone's above the age of 19, you pervs. It is a 200% increase. All right, I don't know about you, but where I come from, we study trends. We're into this stuff. I don't know many industries. I don't know many things right now that are a 200% increase. Dancing in a thong is a 200% increase year over year. How about that balance sheet? Jeff, who is it? All right. If you know them, I think you suck. Just me. I think you got issues. Let's see. Top of the list. Who's number one? She made, I know it's going to shock you, she made $18 million in 2021.
That's 18 million in how much work? Like 5 minutes? Seriously, how many minutes is that? Oh, old man, you don't know. Yeah, you're damn right I don't know. And you're a perf if you do know. She made $17.5 million in 2021. 133 million followers. Good job, guys. Nice. Number two on the list, made $12 million last year. 57 million followers. Number three on the list. That's going to shock you. That's a middle-aged... No, it's not. $8.5 million. Who are the names, Jeff? Who are the names? You know the names. Let's see. Number three is Addison Rae. She made $8.5 million in 2021, had 86 million followers. Okay? I mean, she only made from 2020 to 2021. I assume Addison Rae came up with a different, math formula? She won a Nobel Prize, COVID something or other. Is that what she did, or just having longer dance? She made $3 million more in 2021 than 2020. So it seems to me the curve here is a pretty dramatic increase. I like to say, kids, you should only have to make $15 million once. Okay? So that's a good year. So if you said, you know what she's going to do, Jeff? She's going to retire and code software, or retire and go fly fish. Okay, you should only have to make $15 million once. The great Addison Rae, Nobel Prize winner, Gandhi herself, made $8.5 million in 2021. Number two on the list is the great, and she also, I mean, she was the one who, she went, where was she in Africa where she had that COVID test that she was helping poor people? No, she danced in her underwear. Dixie, I'm supposed to know the name, right? D'Amelio, D apostrophe A-M-E-L-I-O. Dixie had a pretty good year as well. Dixie had 57 million followers, and she made $10 million last year on TikTok. Number one, though, shockingly, is her sister, who's 17. How's that working out at the house? I can imagine this house. Man, are you proud or are you disgusted? How does that work? At 17 million bucks is... Wonder how long before Dad steals it all. Let's make a prediction on how things end up at the D'Amelio house. Probably I know nothing about them, but I think we know how it works out when the teen daughters make a bunch of money. So let's say if they make 17. So between the two of them, sister and big sister, a 200% increase for Charlie, C-H-A-R-L-I, Charlie 17. She made $17.5 million last year, 133 million followers. So in one household, we've got close to $30 million. How long is that going to last? How long before Dad screws it off? So there you go. It's $56 million. Just the top three earners, shockingly all teenage girls, made close to $40 million just between three of them for what? About, what would that be? In a total year, would that be 2 hours of work? See, it's free enterprise is a beautiful thing. Free enterprise is a disgusting thing.
From the Hot Pie Media Studios in Austin, Texas, it's the Jeff Ward Show. Listen at jeffwardshow.com.